Good day and peace be with you. Thank you for joining on this online parents orientation for academic year 2021-2022. And this is our primary goal, to give a sense of community of the students, parents, teachers, and staff by providing opportunities by communication introduction and interaction to provide information in our goals, regulations, programs, facilities, and services of the school, and how this can support the academic and personal goals, especially with the pandemic we are facing right now. I am Ms. Mary Joanne G. Marquez, and I will be your host for today's online parents orientation. To start with, let us officially commence our gathering today by asking divine intervention as Mr. John Vincent Perez, subject team leader of CLV department, lead us all in prayer.
Before we start our opening prayer, may I ask all of you to dispose yourselves and center your mind and heart to our Lord. Let's be aware of Christ's presence in our hearts and adore His holy name. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, Father of onward progression of life and love, we give you thanks that you have sent forth your Son, Jesus Christ, to show and teach us the clearest onward way of truth and light, which leads us constantly in our eight-decade mission. We are lifting up our thanksgiving as one community for the grace-filled years you have bestowed and to the following years ahead of us. We ask for your Holy Spirit to guide us with our online parents orientation and our activities moving forward, to have dialogue so that we may have enlightenment in our hopes, to have faith so that we may go onward your way, and to have strength so that we may live out your will. May this gathering lead us onward to a faith-driven mission to the least, the lost, and the last. We praise you with our lips, with our lives and hearts as we praise you. Mary, our mother and model, pray for us. St. Paul, our patron, pray for us. Father Louis Chauvet and the First Sisters, intercede for us. May the love of Christ impel us now and forever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Once again, a pleasant day to all. On behalf of entire SPCM community, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to all of you. Before we get started with our online orientation, I would like to remind everyone that we will have time for questions at the end of the presentations from our different speakers for today using the Mentimeter. Later on, we will flash on our screen the code that you need to type in to join. Again, for the reminders, For your questions and clarifications, you may go to www.menti.com and use the code 848-57621. Thank you. And now, to officially welcome us for today's orientation, I am pleased to introduce to you our new school director's principal, Sister Mirna Castante SPC. Good day, Sister.
Good day, dear parents and guardians. Welcome to this virtual orientation. Thank you very much for believing in Polinian education by sending your children to St. Paul College of Makati. We thank God for all the graces He has given us this past school year. We thank Him that we are still in good health amidst this pandemic. This global crisis has taught us important basic lessons in life. We have realized how weak and fragile we are as human beings. We have learned to value more our health and family as truly essentials in life. We are reminded to be more concerned with others, especially our neighbors. In her New Year's message last January 2021, our provincial superior emphasized to us, and I quote, "The crisis has challenged us to react and respond in a different way, with faith and not with fear. The pandemic has also become an opportunity for us to know ourselves better in how we respond to and deal with the needed change and adjustment," unquote. St. Paul College of Makati recognizes its role in providing quality education despite challenging times. We strive to ensure that education continues despite the ongoing pandemic while observing proper health protocols. The school has adjusted its curriculum, educational services, and processes through its HEAL program, that is, home-based engagements and alternative learning program. You, dear parents and guardians, are our valuable partners in the education of your children. This cannot be overemphasized, especially this time of pandemic, because your children are with you at home. We are giving this orientation so that we may have a fruitful partnership with you in this endeavor. So again, welcome to this virtual orientation. Caritas Christi urgent nos.
Thank you very much, Sister Mirna, for that welcoming message of yours. At this juncture, I would like to flex our hardworking, supportive, and innovative person behind the HEAL Program 2.0, our very own Assistant Academic Services Head, Mr. Raymond Andre C. Samonte. Good day, sir.
Thank you very much, Ms. Joanne, for that generous introduction. Also, good day to our dear parents. Hello to our students. Let me be the first one to welcome everyone for the school year 2021 to 2022. So for our school learning continuity plan for this school year, we will be launching, or we had already launched our HEAL program 2.0, now version 2.0, so to speak, of our online distance learning modality. So let us deal with the different features, or probably the different features of the program. Next slide, please. So the rationale of our HEAL program would be as follows. This program is organized to ensure that education continues despite ongoing pandemic, while observing proper health protocols. So the school adjusts its curriculum, educational services and processes to deliver alternative learning setups as schools face the new normal. Next slide. Our curriculum for the HEAL Program 2.0 would still be integrating the outcomes-based education framework of the Sisters of St. Paul of Chartres Education Ministry. So in our curriculum, it is already embedded the Paulinian learning outcomes. And also, the DepEd or the Department of Education's most essential learning competencies. Together with this, we had come up with the different learning domains of the K-12 curriculum. The list would be seen at the bottom side of, or the bottom slide. Thank you. Next slide, please. For that, we had opened our HEAL program 2.0 for early years, elementary, junior high school, senior high school, with the different strands of STEM, UMS, and GAS. Next slide. In terms of the instructional delivery, there are two ways by which we will be delivering instruction. One is through online distance learning. The online distance learning is using online learning platforms for lecture, tasks, and other learning activities. To enrich the learning experience of the Paulinians, we had also integrated home-based tasks, which refers to the offline works or home-based activities through the use of learning packet worksheets. So this is quite unique in our program because some are really going for full online distance learning, while on our end, we have integrated home-based tasks in order for us to get a mix of online screen and off-screen activities. Next slide, please. So learning can happen in two ways. In our HEAL program, you would see that learning can happen in either in synchronous learning or asynchronous learning. So synchronous learning would be about having simultaneous online learning tasks, or the teacher and the students are accessing the learning materials online simultaneously. And for the asynchronous learning, the learners would be accessing the learning materials at their own pace or availability. Next slide, please. A part of our HEAL program is that each student will be given a printed worksheet. And then in every account, student account as well, each will be given an online learning packet. So what is this online learning packet? It contains different parts of a learning module. So this is a teacher-made learning module for all our students. This was made and checked thoroughly by our subject team leaders and the academic team. And then this will be given through the learning management system and the SPCM student mail account, while the printed worksheets contain the learning tasks that are aligned to the development of the learning outcome. So more likely, these are the exercises, the different off-screen tasks given to the students. Next slide. So the printed worksheets are released per quarter. It may be picked up from a school or have it couriered, depending on your choice. The distribution dates will be scheduled and announced. It seems that I have lost connection. Let me repeat the last part of what I said. So the courier or the printed worksheets may be picked up from school or have it couriered by your choice. So the distribution dates will be scheduled and announced in our online platforms. So we would just like to request the parents that to be updated on our distribution dates. Okay, next slide, please. The duration of the synchronous learning per subject is also, or would consider also, the learning screen time of the students. So we had come up with certain ways by which we could have a breathing time, and the eyes of the students are also, or the health, the physical health of our students would also be considered. So the early years would be having 15 minutes per subject. You might ask, why do they have 15 minutes? Because they have only a few subjects, okay? For grades 1 to 3, we have 40 minutes. For grades 4 to 12, we also have 50 minutes. So a 10 minutes gap between the subject is also placed. So again, so that the students can also breathe a little bit, no? Or probably can close their eyes for quite some time so that they would not have a screen fatigue. So twice a week meeting will also be done for the key learning areas, the ones that I have mentioned a while ago, and once a week meeting for other subjects. So a 20 minutes mentoring period is also given at the end of the day. This time, the mentoring period will be more structured, and everybody will be required to be in the mentoring period. The mentoring period will be now avenues or opportunities for the teachers to really coach and guide the students how to do their learning tasks, or probably their printed worksheets. Okay, so the teachers, or rather the students, would no longer have another excuse not to do their worksheets. So this is also one way for us to help the learners achieve the learning outcome. Next slide. This is the class schedule of the pre-kinder or of the early years department. You would see here that there are 4 synchronous sessions, and then the Wednesday sessions will be dedicated for the PRISM, or the Polynesian Roots, Identity, Spirituality, and Mission sessions, as well as the lead sessions and homeroom sessions. So if you would also notice that the Wednesday, you will have a joint meeting for the AM and the PM session, because we saw the need for the socialization of the students. Even if we are virtually connected, it's really different when the students would be conversing. So we saw this as an opportunity. The Wednesdays are saw as opportunities by which the students can really interact with one another. So the AM and PM sessions will be combined so that we could have only one homeroom session or PRISM session. Next slide, please. This is the class schedule for grades 1 to 3. So similarly, you have 4 days of synchronous sessions, and Wednesday for homeroom, PRISM, and lead sessions. Okay, this is now for grades 4 to 12. Next slide, please. The class ratio for the early years to grade 3 is at least 1:15, and for grades 4 to 12, 1:20. That is per session. However, actual ratio depend on the actual enrollment, but it will not be more than 1:18 for the early years to grade 3 and 1:25 for grades 4 to 12. Why did we say that the actual ratio depends on the actual enrollment? Because for some cases, we really had to consider those parents who are also working online, who are working from home. There are also cases in the family contexts wherein there are shared devices, and we could not anymore, or the family could not anymore buy another device. Okay, next slide, please. In terms of our online learning platforms and video conferences, we would be using Genio for the early years to grade 10 and Schoology for grades 11 to 12. This has been our learning management systems that we have been using for quite some time. So for those students who are with us since then, they know very well now how to navigate and access them. But for the new students and the parents, please do not worry, because there would be an online orientation in the usage and access of Genu and Schoology as well. And in terms of our main video conferencing platform, we would be using Google Meet. We have seen that in terms of the bandwidth consumption, Google Meet proved to be more likely an efficient video conferencing platform. No? Okay, so I think we are experiencing currently some internet connection, intermittent internet connection, so sorry for that. But rest assured that the session is recorded and you may view it again in the YouTube school YouTube channel, no, or YouTube platform. Okay, so for our students and parents this time, or this year, we are also working on a parent SPCM mail account. Now, before, we only have the students. We did not yet release the parent accounts because we saw in our enrollment form that some of the enrollees have not filled out the form. So it caused quite a difficulty on our end. So we were not able to generate all of the parents' email, more likely because some of the parents did not also indicate their registered email, no, and then their information. Okay, so but rest assured that we would be releasing it before the school year starts, so that we teachers or other offices can also communicate on with both students and parents. So we would be using Google Workspace for Education. This is known formerly as G Suite for Education. And then video conferences are an integral part of the instructional delivery. You might ask why we are actually requiring video conferences or their cameras to be on. It's because we also want to see their reactions. We also want to see their body languages when we have the synchronous sessions. Now, it's also a way for us to socialize with the learners. And then video meetings are recorded and kept by the teacher. It may be accessed upon request to the teachers. No? So in case that your students or that your child is absent for one day, you could catch up with the different sessions through the video recorded meetings. So please do not also worry, because it is protected by the Data Privacy Act. Next slide, please. For the assessments, formative and summative assessments are geared towards skills-based or performance-based. There will be no major online examinations this year. Last year, I think we had two online examinations, but based on student, parent, and teacher feedback, it is more beneficial. Like we could more likely assess the learning if we go for performance-based. So this time, the summative assessment will be done in a form of performance-based task. Next slide, please. Performance-based tasks are also articulated this year to lessen the number of tasks per grade level. So since last year, it was the birthing pain, so to speak, of the HIL program. So it's a new program for all of us. We did not yet have the articulation for the performance task. So this time, we had already met with the different grade level teachers and had articulated the performance tasks, no, so that we could lessen the number of tasks per grade level. And then we also have collaborative assessment. this time we already had a standing policy that it is limited to not more than 4 learners per group, so that everybody will have their own corresponding responsibilities and be independent on their tasks. Next slide. In terms of our academic conduct and special awards, it is still temporarily suspended since there are different learning contexts or learning environment. Some might have good internet connections, some might have more learning resources than others. So it is best to have, or to suspend rather, these awards. However, in terms of the recognition medals for completers and graduates, we would be giving them based on their manifestations of the Paulinian learning outcomes. So for the completers and the graduates, you would be also oriented with the criteria on the recognition for the recognition medals for the Paulinian learning outcomes. Next slide. In all our outputs, we will be following an honesty pledge system. This is to be attested by students and the parents. This is also one way for the parents to check if their children are actually submitting the outputs. Then students must also hold intellectual property rights in their outputs. Proper citation of online and written outputs must be present. So this is a sample of the honesty pledge that we are appending on each student output. So the parents are again requested to sign these honesty pledges so that you would also be aware of what kind of output are they doing in the virtual class. Next slide, please. This is the computer unit system requirement. Kindly see the different specifications of the computer unit. We are recommending that we have one, either desktop or laptop, with working front camera or web camera. It is also best if you have headphones or earphones, because so that the sound in the atmosphere or in the environment of the learner will not be heard. And then the student can also concentrate. Next slide. These are the different software programs that the learners would be using. This is for different grade levels. So you would more likely see these programs being used by the learners. Okay. As for the minimum requirements for devices when accessing our online learning platforms, remember they may be accessed via your device, I mean the desktop or the laptop, or it may be accessed via your iPads or cell phones. So please make sure that that your devices have this minimum requirements. Okay. Now for the role of the parents, I had made it into an acronym. No, what is the role of the parents? So you have SPCM. The role of the parents would be, number one, it's actually a shared responsibility. Parents are seen now as co-animators of learning. No? Gone are the days that the parents are not involved in the classroom, because remember, your homes are now part of the classroom, you know, part of the school already. And then parents are also supporters. No? It's as part of the shared responsibility. Also, a part of it is periodic mentoring. In a sense that in terms of providing a certain support for our learners, we could have periodic mentoring to our learners. Or probably if you would like to be mentored on how to access the LMS, you could let us know. Okay. Also, in terms of constant communication and being a collaborator, since we already have now a parent male account, we could better communicate and collaborate with the teachers. And then we also have to be mindful in giving our feedback and how to monitor the learners. This is just my request to the parents, that whenever we make or we give feedback to our learners, please be mindful, because they are also stressed, no? Having online distance learning modality. So hindi po natin alam, baka mamaya po nagkakaroon ng mga signs of depression or anxiety yung mga bata. We have to be mindful of our feedback, especially they are 24/7 at home. Okay. Next slide, please. For the HIL program help desk, you may ask the different offices or the different emails here in terms of the general inquiries, school records, admission, and guidance services, and as well as technical support. You may ask each of our departments on how we could better assist you for the online learning of the students. Okay, next slide. Now, please be informed that the opening of classes is moved to August 2, 2021. No, we have not yet formally announced this one in our social media platforms, but you will be the first one to be informed of this, because this was already just released to us yesterday, no? It is for us to have a synchronization on the school calendar of other Polynesian schools. So the SPCEM or the Education Ministry is working towards one system or one flow of activities. And if we begin in early in July, we will not be able to attend some of our activities or our ministry-wide activities, no? So it is best to move it a bit, also for other parents also to prepare for the online learning. We also have to prepare now the learning packets more or better, and also for our enrollees, no? Baka po kasi meron pang mga gusto mag-enroll sa atin, they would have more time. Okay. So to better synchronize our school calendars for all Polynesian schools, we would have August. No? Next one, may I present to you the highlights of the learning preference survey. So we had done this learning preference survey last January, participated by the students, parents, and even teachers. So based on their answers, they still prefer online distance learning for this school year. No? And then we also have the blended learning for 31% and other modes of learning. So more likely, may touch pa rin po talaga ng online distance learning or ng online learning yung ating mode of learning for this school year. Okay? Next one is the overall rating for the HIL program. We have the overall rating is 2.94, which is satisfactory and effective based on the survey. And these are the five departments or areas or for the student services or for the services that we had. So we had the Christian formation, registrar information, faculty and teachers competence, and administration. Sige po. Next slide, please. There are also the top five considerations on learning modality. We have the observance on the IATF and the DepEd regulations, safety and security of learners, teacher competence, school location and accessibility, and class schedule and time allotment. So these are the considerations that the parents, students had made when enrolling. So more likely po talaga, we would be having the health, safety, and security as the top consideration or major consideration. Next slide, please. Then also there are the five aspects that you like best in the HEAL program. So many of the respondents said that in terms of accommodation and adjustment, they appreciated the implementation of the HEAL program. Also the expanded opportunities, considerations for health protocols. If you notice, we really had done expanded opportunities for the learners last year. Even if it's fourth quarter, we are still accepting outputs from the first quarter, just so that we could consider all of the things that had happened during online classes. No, we also were not so strict in terms of how we implement on things, because we are more likely trying out on things, no? And hopefully this year we could better adjust, we could better implement the HEAL program. And then we also have the curriculum and instructional delivery, that's 30%, administrators and faculty competence, learning packet and online learning tools, and then the school activities and learning support program. So these are the five aspects that the respondents said that they like best in the HEAL program. Next. These are the common challenging aspects in terms of the HEAL program. So you have number one, internet connection concern. So similarly, on our end, we also experience intermittent internet connections. So this is something that hopefully, the national government can improve on. No? And then we also have the general difficulty adapting to online learning. So since this is the first year that we had implemented it, so everybody adjusted, the students, parents, even the teachers, no? Even sometimes even the grandparents, because they are the ones assisting the learners. You also have technological limitations in terms of how to navigate or to access the LMS, the email, no? Even last night, no, I was also monitoring the different concerns in the email, so that I would know if they had already received the link. So some of the parents or the students might not have received them. That's why we are actually recording this one, so that they would also be able to view the parents' orientation. And then also there are home contexts and the limitations, so the space and conducive environment for learning and the distractions at home. So this is something that I would like to request the parents also to probably provide a conducive environment for the learners. And then you also have the number and complexity of tasks. I am also somehow seeing the Mentimeter questions here. So some of the questions is about the number and the complexity of the tasks. So we are trying to work on that. So that that's why we had the articulated performance-based tasks, so that we could lessen somehow the number of the learning tasks done per quarter. And at this time, we had also tried to schedule which ones will going to have a major task, which ones will not be, so that it could provide a better learning environment, no, for our children. Next slide, please. And then we also have the most common comments and the suggestions. So most of the comments are really about the positive feedback on the HEAL program. So we also would like to thank you, dear parents, for the support that you are giving the school for our HEAL program. And then we also have comments and suggestions on the learning packet, and then the unified structure system of information and communication. We have now established a policy regarding this one. So I hope it would be better this time. We always say that we have a policy of having the LMS as the standard of submission, and in terms of communication, the mail SPCM student or parent mail account. No? And then for the schedule of class and the parents' involvement. Okay, next slide, please. So these are the innovations that we have thought of for this school year for the HIL program. Number one is the increased number of synchronous sessions, articulated the performance tasks, performance-based assessments in place of the summative tests, creation of SPCM parent mail account, reactivation of the student activities and the student government. So we'll try to inject again, once again, the student activities, since we believe that a learner should have a holistic development. No? So last year po kasi we focused on the academics because we really do not know how to operate. So this time we'll try to inject some parts and bits, no, of online student activities. And then we will also be providing infographics and video tutorials for the LMS navigation and access. Okay, so next slide. All right, so with that, again, I would like to thank you for your support for the HIL program. We are always open for points for improvement, but again, the love of Christ always impels us to do things better and excellently. So with that, thank you very much, Caritas, Christy, or Jetnos.
Once again, thank you very much, Mr. Samonte. As of the moment, I can see a few questions coming in. Again, as I mentioned a while ago, our speakers will address all your concerns before we end the orientation. Thank you. With that, I hope that you were able to grasp the idea of our HIL program 2.0, as well as digest some of the innovations made in terms of curriculum, instructional delivery, and assessment. And to give details about the homeroom concerns, please help me welcome our homeroom team leader, Mrs. Luz Sarmiento. Good day, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Joanne. So good day, dear parents. We are glad to have you with us today in this online orientation. This opportunity will give us a chance to get acquainted with important matters that concern us in our children. The formation process of your child or children is not the sole responsibility of the school, but it is a long-term partnership between the home and the school, especially this time of pandemic. Therefore, both the parents and the teachers need to be active partners in the continuing process of our children's education. I wish to emphasize that the school and the home need to consolidate efforts in the realization of their common goal, the Christian education and the formation of our children. I enjoin your support of the school's vision mission in molding the minds and hearts of our children. In the area of discipline, the students are being taught to be morally and socially responsible by training them to have self-discipline through their observance of good manners and right conduct, religious practices, practice of good virtues, and their loyalty to the school rules and regulations. To achieve this discipline among the students, the school had set some guidelines and disciplinary measures for strict implementation. So may I present to you now my slides? So again, the RHDP, or the Revitalized Homeroom Guidance Program. So homeroom is making the class a home where the pupils or students can feel relaxed while on a journey towards self-awareness, self-acceptance, and eventually towards self-actualization. Next slide, please. Okay, for the guidelines for student attendance, for letter A, we have the flag ceremony. So pupils and students who fail to attend the morning or afternoon rites will be considered tardy for the first period. Number two, pupils or students going in beyond 7:40 a.m. and or 12:40 p.m. will be considered tardy. Next slide, please. For online classes, number one, pupils or students who miss one or two subjects per day will be marked as cutting classes. However, non-attendance for three subjects per day will be considered as absence for the whole day. Next slide, please. Now, reasons to be considered excused. For letter A, we have Wi-Fi or internet connection problems. Parents should inform or write an excuse letter to Sister Mierna through the class advisor about the problem and should send proof like a screenshot of their connection issues. Non-submission of excuse letters will not be marked excused in the attendance, but students or pupils are excused if they get disconnected for 5 to 15 minutes. Next slide, please. For sickness or injury, parents should inform the principal or advisor through a letter. In case of long absence due to sickness, parents are expected to communicate to the principal or advisor through a letter and submit a medical certificate. Next slide, please. Then there are also excuses for emergency cases and the death of an immediate family member. Now, please take note, the three recorded incidents of tardiness is equivalent to one absence. Next slide, please. Okay, for the proper school uniform. Okay, now for the pupils and students are requested to wear the school uniform. So they are not allowed to wear pajamas or home clothes during the online session. Next slide, please. So for boys' school uniform, it should be white tetherum polo shirt with an SPCM patch, no slit at the back or at the sides for early years to grade 10. White Santana polo barong with an SPCM pin for senior high school, and plain white sandals should be tucked. Next slide, please. Then khaki shorts for early years and grade to grade 2, khaki pants for grades 3 to 6, dark blue pants slacks for junior high school, and black pants slacks for senior high school. Then plain white socks for early years to grade 6, plain black socks for grades 7 to 12. Of course, if they are going to wear black leather shoes, and it must be clean polished if that is not online. Okay, next slide, please. For the girls, white blouse with navy collar for early years to grade 10, short sleeve white tetherum blouse for senior high school, plain white sando or white chemise, checkered diamond shape necktie for early years, checkered bow tie for grade school, checkered necktie for junior high school, and black necktie with SPCM pin for senior high school. Next slide, please. Black checkered round pleated skirt must be at least 2 inches below the knee for early years to grade 10. And black checkered front pleated skirt must be at least 2 inches below the knee. And plain white socks with no ruffles, ankle socks are not allowed for early years to grade 10. Skin tone or black foot socks or skin tone stockings for senior high school. Next, please. And then black flat-heeled leather shoes for early years to grade 10, black leather shoes with 2-inch heels for senior high school. Grooming for boys. Haircut must be neat-looking and presentable. Wearing of earrings is not allowed, and fingernails must be short and clean. Next slide, please. For girls, long hair must be neatly tied. Bangs should not reach the eyebrows. Fingernails must be short and clean, and wearing or dangling in multiple earrings is not allowed. Next slide, please. For netiquette for online classes. So netiquette refers to rules of etiquette that apply to online communication. So students should stay on topic. They should avoid posting, uploading, liking, or sharing objectionable material like pictures, videos, blogs, or comments in the internet or through other means, such as the use of mobile phones, among others. Next slide, please. They should always remember to say please and thank you when soliciting help from their teacher. Now, during discussion, they should respect the opinion of their classmates. If they feel the need to disagree, they should do so respectfully. Students should avoid spreading misinformation. Next slide, please. They should avoid circulating false or malicious information about any individual or group, which may be done verbally, in writing, or through electronic means. Cyberbullying or online bullying is highly discouraged. They should not view or access any form of immoral, obscene, or indecent material, whether electronic or in print. Next slide, please. Another, for pupils or students, they are expected to keep their cameras on and microphones off during classes, except when they are called to recite. Parents should inform the class advisor through a letter if their children's camera and or microphone is or not working. Next slide, please. Okay. So please provide a conducive learning environment for your children. So a well-ventilated, well-lit space free from most distractions like noise, family members walking to and fro, other gadgets or gaming consoles. Pupils and students are supposed to remain focused with their online classes and must not be given errands during classes if it can be avoided. Because we experience this, yung ibang mga reasons for their being tardy or absent ay dahil daw po ay inutusan sila ng kanilang mga parents. So I hope this can be avoided. And then, the pupils or students' background must be clear and pleasant so as not to distract others. Okay? So, their parents, if in cases of infractions of school rules and regulations, the Committee on Student Welfare is convened. Now, in consonance with the due process, the body receives and reviews evidence of any case for deliberation and imposes a sanction upon the approval of the director's principal. But don't worry, parents, because we apply restorative discipline. So as I end, I would like to share this, dear parents. Most of the disciplinary or behavioral problems of our children can be avoided if we get involved in their lives, get interested in what they do, reach out and know who their friends are, communicate with the school, attend meetings like this, and confer with teachers. Why so? Because when we do this, our children will know, feel, and experience the love that they need most at this point in their lives. So my dear parents, we look forward to a fruitful partnership between the home and the school. Thank you very much. God bless us all.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Sarmiento. Again, if you happen to miss some of the important details with regard to homeroom rules and regulations, you may view and watch this orientation at the school's YouTube account. Thank you. And to give us details on guidance services, it is my pleasure to introduce to you our guidance counselor, Ms. Vanessa Agris. Good day, ma'am.
Okay. Good day, dear parents and our students. I will be discussing with you one of the student services that the St. Paul College of Makati is offering, and that is our guidance services. Next slide, please. So the guidance center operates as a service arm of the school. The services are extended primarily to the students and the pupils. However, we are also opening our doors to our adult community, which includes our personnel and staff, our teachers, as well as you, our dear parents. Next slide, please. So the purpose of the guidance or the goals of our center is to contribute to the learners' growing awareness and understanding their developing self-concepts, attitudes, and values, as well as psychological, emotional, social, and moral maturity, so that they may be holistically developed, they can achieve their maximum potential, and they can also create their own niche in the field that they are going to enter into after graduation from college. Next slide, please. The Guidance Center operates under the framework, which is based from the American School Counselor Association. So this is the model. All our programs and our services are being implemented as a response to the call for us to provide services in terms not just of personal and social development, but also academic and career development. Next slide, please. So the guidance counselors at present, for the boys is Mr. Jan Chi Resco. So he will be handling the boys from early years to senior high school. Next slide, please. And I will be handling the girls from early years to senior high school. Next slide, please. Okay. So as Sir Sam said, and as reiterated by Mrs. Sarmiento earlier, we are working hand in hand with you, dear parents, in fostering the holistic development of your children. Your presence is really critical in these times, because they are at home. They are learning alongside you, most of you who are working at home as well. So it's very important that the children also not just feel your physical presence, but that you are there to support them in all their endeavors. So we enjoin you to foster regular communication with your children, to ask them how they are adapting or adjusting to the new modalities of learning, especially for those who are going to school for the first time for our early years. And then, of course, encourage good study habits as much as possible. They would not be distracted and they could concentrate on their homework and on the answering their learning packets and their worksheets. And of course, let us provide opportunities for independence and self-regulation so that they may be able to address or cope with their stresses on their own, with assistance, of course, from you, but we want them to be able to enjoy their independence, even if they are at home, and to also learn how to manage and how to do their tasks, as we have seen earlier, they are being asked to complete their task independently, and on their own. So this is also one way to let them try, how it is, especially when they are preparing for the real world, how they are going to survive and thrive when they graduate from schools. Next slide, please. And of course, help them to find balance between school and work, between school work and leisure. It's not always, that's why our sessions is either morning or afternoon. It's also to provide opportunities for our children to relax and to find things to do that they can enjoy, like their own hobbies. They can also do other activities, other self-learning activities, especially for those who are in grades 11 and 12. While they are preparing for college, they are getting some certifications, they're doing this because this will be their way to also decompress from the stresses of not just the screen time, but also from the work, you know, the work that they are doing in school. And of course, be a model of a helpful coping mechanism, because we as parents, as we all know, we become the models of behavior. Now, what we do is usually being copied by our student or by our children. So we also have to show them, you know, how to manage emotions, how to manage our thoughts, you know, so that they will also be turning to us when they need assistance, and they will also be doing their own self-care and self-help in order to address their common stresses. Next slide, please. So what to look out for, no, whenever when we communicate with our teachers, we will learn, oh, sometimes our children have not been submitting their output on time, or they have been late or tardy, then maybe, no, there have been some stresses that they are feeling, and that contributes to their lack of focus, to their lack of motivation, no? So we have to look out for the signs of stress, like decreasing sleep or insomnia, no, or sometimes sleeping for the whole day, and loss of appetite, or sometimes it can also manifest as stress eating, no, having depressed mood. Okay, they have also fears and worries, especially when it comes to the future, no, what will happen, or even what is happening around the world. And they may have negative thoughts, and some illnesses, no, like migraines or headaches or stomach aches, no, that may be a sign of stress and not medically, kumbaga, it's not medical, but rather as a symptom of stress. Okay, we also have to look out for changes in attitudes and behavior. No, they are becoming aggressive or defiant, no, they may be also engaging in bullying, no, or sometimes they are victims of bullying and they become passive, they become submissive, no, and sometimes they turn to negative coping mechanisms, no, they would engage in risky behaviors, no, some self-harm. Okay, so we need to look out for those signs, especially now it's a very challenging time, and all around us the world is suffering from the pandemic, no, and although we are continuing to survive and to thrive, there are still COVID related or pandemic related fears and worries and depressions, no, so we have to look out for these signs in our children. And if they are struggling academically, again, no, it may be a sign of the stresses that they are experiencing, and not because they cannot cope, no, with the task at hand, but rather there is a lack of focus or lack of energy, lack of motivation to complete the task being assigned to them. Okay. And isolation and withdrawal, no, they won't talk to you, or they won't talk to their friends or their siblings. So especially when they have concerns or issues, sometimes they would not discuss it with you, maybe for fear that they might be scolded, or maybe they don't want to be embarrassed because of the issues or concerns that they have. So please encourage them, no, to when you notice that they are not talking, please encourage them to ask help, no, or to confide in you, no. You will now become their best friends, especially that they are not with their friends or classmates at this time. Next slide, please. So what can you do as parents, no? Of course, no, we remind our children that your home is a safe and a secure environment, and that they can trust you that whatever it is that they will be undergoing, the stressors that they are experiencing, you will be there to support them and provide assistance. And as much as possible, maintain family routines, no, so that they can also have a semblance of the normalcy that they have experienced prior to the pandemic. Okay, and keep them informed of and involved in what is happening in the family. No, some instances when the family have to move to the province because of some financial concerns, or it is better to move to the other to live with other family members because they have a more internet connectivity. No, the internet connectivity is more stable in the other house. So they have to be also involved and participate in these decisions because it also affects their lives. And it will also be important that they know what is happening around the world, no, especially with the pandemic. Okay. However, we have to also monitor their viewing and surfing habits, that they do not access false information or some reports that may be depressing and can cause more anxiety, no, like mga negative news or reports, no. So we have to also monitor their television and internet habits. Okay. And as much as possible, no, we still want to spend quality time with them. Even though if most of you or some of you are working from home, even though you are together the whole day, it's different when you can just turn off all your gadgets or, you know, take a day off and spend it with them, just relaxing, having fun, no, have a kamustahan session with them, and just a little bit of connectivity and socializing, so that they can also relax, no, from the schoolwork. Okay. Next slide, please. So aside from all those things that we can do to help our children, let us also remember, no, the five protective factors. No, first is we need support. No, we will not be able to do this alone. No, especially if our children's concern will be on the kumbaga, it will no longer be able to cope on their own, or it will no longer be possible to do self-care, then we ask the help of the professionals, okay, especially those with some diagnosis, no. We also have to be open to our school counselor, so that we will know how to further assist your children. Even if they are at home, we can still extend our service to them, okay? And of course, no, our commitment to be the model to our children in terms of coping mechanisms, okay? And encouraging them, of course, to be connected to their friends, no, and even talk to their teachers if they need mentoring, okay? And so to kumbaga, take advantage of the mentoring sessions that are being offered by our teachers. And we also have to remember, no, that our guidance services, even if we are online, sige ma'am, continue po. We can still provide, no, the necessary services should you need to. Okay. So one of our service, please, next slide. Yan, is the individual counseling. So this is done through Google Meet. Okay. Individual counseling, for this, no, we would require the student to sign a consent form, and also for the parents, no, to sign a confidentiality agreement and disclose of information. So what is the disclose of information? Disclose of information is when there is a need for the school counselor to consult with teachers, okay, or with other colleagues, no, in so that we can provide you the best support. So we will be asking you to sign this document, no. The consent form will be signed by both the student or the parent, so that we will know that the student is also willing to undergo counseling. Okay, so we cannot force them to undergo counseling. We can only encourage them to come to us and seek assistance. Okay, so again, no, this is done via Google Meet, and we also do online individual consultations. So you may want to discuss some concerns, ask for some pieces of advice, then we will be very much willing to accommodate you. Okay. Next slide, please. So we also have group counseling and consultation. So what happens in group counseling is when there are students or group of students who have the similar concerns, no? Like, for example, they need assistance for, let's say, assertiveness or more on time management. Then students with the same concerns will be grouped and will be given group process or group dynamics. Okay. And also consultation, it will also involve parents and teachers, no? Like a parent teacher and a guidance counselor conference, also via Google Meet. Next slide, please. Okay, so how to avail of the services? So there are two ways, no, from your end on how to avail. No, first is to fill up the Google form, either by the student or by the parents, or to inquire through our Facebook account or through our email, which I will be flashing later. Next slide, please. So for the student request for appointment, so this will be what the student will see. We will be providing you the link once you contact us, no, via our email or our Facebook. Okay. So the student request, so they will be indicating their concerns. They will choose, no, if they want to talk with Mr. John or with me. Okay. So like we said, Sir John will be the one handling for boys. But if your student will be more comfortable talking to him, then that is okay. No, it doesn't have to be exclusive, the services that either Sir John or I offer. No, and then they can also choose the concern, no, either it's academic, no, either personal or social or career, or there are other concerns, okay. And then for the priority of request, is this a crisis situation or not? For a crisis situation, this of course involves instances wherein there are thoughts or attempts or plans to harm themselves or to harm others. So my dear parents, no, we encourage you to seek assistance, if not with us, then with a professional, no, to especially in cases like this. No, we also have our own network of professionals that we can tap to assist our students. Okay, so if it is a crisis situation, we will respond to it as soon as possible. But if not, no, then they can schedule a time and date when they will be available to meet with the counselor. And then if they want a continuing session, then when will it be, no? and then other information that they would want us to know. Okay. We would just like to emphasize, since they are minors, no, that's why we are asking you to sign the consent form, because they are minors, no, and there are also instances when we may have to call you for consultation as well. For the protection of our students, okay, we will adhere to the strictest confidentiality and data privacy law and ethics. Okay, you will have access to your student information unless, of course, there are some information that the guidance counselor may deem not necessary to be shared to the parents, or some information that may be detrimental to the well-being of the children. So not all information and not the details will be given to you. So we will have to filter some information. No? Not because we want to keep things from you, but because our goal is to determine what will work best for our children. Okay, so I hope you understand that some information or details will not be discussed with you, but we will provide you a general impression of what transpired during the counseling session. Okay, and then next slide, please. Next slide po muna. Okay. Ayan, so medyo nagkamali lang po yung heading, no? But this is the parent request for appointment form. So for the parents, this is what you will see, okay? So the name of the parent, no? Your relation or the guardian, no? And your relation. And then the name of the student, nature of the concern. And then we would ask again, no? If it's a priority, if it's a crisis situation or it can wait, no? And then how to contact you, especially if it is a crisis situation, no? We have to implement a safety plan. So we have to also work hand in hand to ensure that our children are safe and there are no potential weapons that they can use to harm themselves. Okay. And then any information also, no? What have you done? So that we know also how to best support your children, no? If you have already consulted with a professional or not yet, no? What self-care or support have you given your children, so that we can also use that as a baseline information with the kind of service or intervention that we can provide, okay? Can you go back po dun sa previous slide? Ayan. So ito naman po, this is actually the referral form, no? So this one will be submitted by the teachers, no? Who will be observing them and monitoring them while in class. So if they notice some changes in the behavior or in the academic performance of the students, they might refer the student to us for consultation or for counseling. So the referral, if the teacher wants it to be anonymous, then we will not disclose, no, who referred, especially if the student has not been informed. So we have naman po policies in place on how to go about it, no, how to manage cases that are being referred to us. So the teacher, you might wonder why we called you for a conference or why we are asking for your signature on the consent form when you haven't naman requested for an appointment or the student haven't requested for an appointment, you know? So it may be because the teacher have referred the student to the counseling for consultation. And please don't feel bad if the teacher feels the need to refer the student, no? Our goal here is to really provide the best support. And it's not judging, it's not labeling, it's not discriminating against your children, but it's for the best, to the best interest of your child, no? So that they may thrive and succeed, especially in this kind of learning environment. Okay, so there will be instances that they will be referred and we might call on you, no, for again for consultation or conference. Okay, so next slide, please. Ayan, so this will now be our official Facebook account, no? So it's Guidance Team St. Paul Makati, and this is our official email address. So you can reach out, you can send us a private message through our Facebook page or send us an email. Okay. So rest assured that it will only be me or Sir John who has access to the Facebook account as well as to our email account. So no other personnel will be able to see your concerns. Okay, next page, please. And so other services that we offer, we have individual inventory. So aside from the admission and the enrollment form that you have filled up, we will also be asking you to provide us information, no? Spectrum of information from your child's needs, some personalities that you have noticed or observed, no? As well as medical information, health information. So this will help us categorize the needs, no? And as well as develop programs and services that is individualized if needed, and also customized to the needs of your children. Okay, so we also provide testing services, standardized tests for intelligence, personality, which will help them also in their career path, no? Assessing their own skills, having an inventory of their interests, so that they will be prepared on what courses or what the strand, no, for grades 11 that they will choose in the future. We also have information service, so we will be sending this via the HEAL bulletin that will be implemented in the coming months. Okay, we also have research and evaluation. This is for us to know, no, your feedback, how are the services of the guidance, and also for program development. So we will use this for our improvement of the program. And placement, no, we will assist in providing information and mentoring to your student, to your children, no, on where to go to school for college, or what strand to take for grade 11. Okay. And we also work hand in hand with our HTL, no, our homeroom team leader, Mrs. Sarmiento earlier, through the homeroom guidance. So there are some modules that will be delivered by the guidance or even by the advisors that caters not just to the academic but also to the personal and career development, no, as we have stated earlier. Okay, so next slide, please. And so this is, again, no, how to contact us. You can call us also via our landline. And again, if you have any questions, the Mentimeter code is written on the lower right of the screen. Okay, so thank you for listening. And again, good day. So let me just remind before we end, no, we are used to observing the golden rule, no, but for this time we would encourage you to follow, no, the platinum rule, which is to treat others the way they want to be treated. This is in recognition of the individual differences of our children, no, especially for those who have more than two kids, no, that they have their own strengths and weaknesses. They have their own capabilities as well as limitations. So let us assist them in the way they needed, no. Sometimes, kasi we have the tendency to generalize, but of course, no, we have to again recognize our own children's individual differences. So please, if you can, no, treat them, no, the way they want to be treated, the way they needed. Okay. So again, thank you and good day.
Thank you very much, Miss Vanessa, for that comprehensive discussion of yours. I am pretty much sure that our guidance counselors are always willing to help and extend their time, most importantly in caring the mental health, well-being of our dear Polonians, considering our current situation. So please do not hesitate to approach them to avail the different guidance services. Once again, thank you very much, Ms. Vanessa. And to give us details on library services, please help me welcome Mr. Arnold Glenn Assis, our school librarian. Good morning, sir.
Thank you, ma'am, for that very warm introduction. So, good day, dear parents and guardian. In behalf of Library Department, I am again Arnold Glenn C. Assis to present you the library orientation. Right, please. With our given situation that everything goes online, this pandemic challenges everyone's coping mechanism, as mentioned din kanina ni Ms. Isai, our guidance team, this pandemic challenges everyone's coping mechanism but made us all versatile. Library have prepared different online programs and services to effectively cater our clients' information needs via remote access to aid their distance learning. So, the library envisions, next slide please, Bulinyan students as effective lifelong learners who are able to access information resources as the root of information literacy. And we also are on the mission of next slide, please. It provides comprehensive resources and services in of the research, teaching, and learning needs of the school, and to instill in the students' lifelong reading habit through use of library and its resources. So this is the same mission and vision with last few years, but still relevant and applicable during this time of virtual learning or everything goes online. So, next. Again, I am Arnold Glenn C. Assis, your librarian, or you can call me Sir Glenn. And we have our library clerk, which is, I think most of you are very familiar with him, Sir Michael Esther Nuvas, or you can call him Sir Michael. All right, to move forward, here are the library services that we can offer. But first, let me mention the library schedule. For the library schedule, we are open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. with a lunch break of 12 noon to 1 p.m. So here are the library services that we can offer in an online setup. So what the library can offer you. First is the library orientation. So just like this, library from time to time will conduct programs and orientation to keep our students updated from the library services. And also this is to reinforce or to enhance the reading and learning foundation of our dear Polinians. So since this is an online setup, I will cut it short and skip the do's and don'ts inside the library. But instead, I will focus on our online services. And of course, it is always an advantage to have a library by your side in helping you or the students in their studies and researches. We have designed the As a Librarian program to address the virtual reference services. So with that, may I present to you the Library is Online service. So this allows students and you, our dear parents and guardians, to access library programs and services via online, wherein we can readily answer your questions and inquiries. Furthermore, you can navigate our services, especially your information needs. First is through, next slide please, through chat. So we encourage our student to like and subscribe the SPCM Library Facebook page as seen on your screen. So this is to keep you updated to any upcoming library activities and announcements. You can send your question and I as a librarian will try to answer those questions accurately and as soon as possible. The second service that we can offer is through the phone call. So you can dial our school landline and follow it up with the local number of 240, which will direct you to the physical library that will be open again from Monday to Friday every 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. And the third and last one is you can also send andun pa rin po tayo sa slide na yun. So you can send our concern through the library's official Gmail account, which is shown in the screen, library@spcmakati.edu.ph. All right. So we also offer the library online services. That means you can access library services in comfort of your homes. So this we call the virtual library. Librarians offer a video chat through Google Meet. Next slide, please. So, yeah. Upon initial increase of our students, librarians will schedule a student for a video conference if needed arises. So by then, the librarians will send a link to their email, and we encourage you, parents and guardians, to accompany them during the video conference. The next one is, what if you want to borrow a physical book? So this is the most or the frequent asked question with today's library. So for this academic year, the library will be allowing you to borrow a physical books. So this will be for 2 weeks or 14 days. So you can borrow 5 library materials at once, 5 library material at once, and it is renewable one time. So this will be for almost a month that you can have the library or the physical books or the library materials if you wish to borrow them. But to promote discipline and to give fair use to everyone, that because there will be just a limited title, or each of us or each student wants to borrow the same title of the book, we will have a limitation. So this is only for just 14 days or 2 weeks, and you can renew them one time. So this is for a whole month. So it is a very fair now, but if the student exceed the due date, they will be have a exceeding fine, which will 5 pesos for each exceeding date per material. So again, this is to promote or to balance the use of the usage of the materials. And if the materials was damaged, there is an option. You can, or the student will replace the exact material. And if there is a latest publication, so yun po yung ipapalit. And then the next, if ever wala talagang mahanap sa market or the material cannot be found to the market, so you will just pay the exact price of the material plus additional 100 pesos for service fee. But if you don't want or you wish na physically the book, so the library can also offer you the DDS, or what we call the document delivery service, as per request by students. So how does this work? If the librarians won't be able to find the information needed by our clients but physically available in our collection, the librarians will scan the specific pages needed from the physical book, as copyright prohibits the contents of the entire book published without consent from the author. It will be sent to the students through their email. Also, next slide, please. The library do online posting. So this is to utilize our Facebook page. The library keep on posting about news, events, current trends, and also updates from our school events and programs. So this is to promote awareness, but at the same time, as a librarian, making them literate and relevant to avoid spreading fake news. And we also do the word of the day. This is one of the example of our online posting. And then the next. So that is the online posting. That is the examples, one of the examples of the library online posting. Next slide, please. The library also conduct a virtual storytelling. And the last one is the book recommendation. Discovery is one of the great joys of reading. So the library do recommend books according to their grade and reading levels. Then let's go for the online databases. So we have the EBSCOhost. It is an online research platform that provides credible e-resources. So I think most of you are familiar with online database, which is the EBSCOhost. So why not Google na lang instead of EBSCOhost? So EBSCOhost features this is the advanced form of a Google, which the students will able to have a basic and advanced search option. They can customize, which modifies EBSCOhost interface branding and feature, including search limiters and expanders, language preferences, if they need other languages, print options, link options, and more. And then this is with the quality database and search feature, EBSCOhost helps students and researchers of all kinds to find information that they need fast. So this will be for their orientation. I will never let this student as a librarian, I will never let them be on their own with this database. So I will make sure as a librarian that they will be fully oriented and fully knowledgeable with our online database. This is for them to maximize and navigate this our subscription with this database. This is to maximize and to let them navigate this database on their own. And with that, this database also can be accessed through mobile phones. So we will teach and we will let the students download the EBSCOhost mobile app. The students are encouraged to use our subscription to EBSCOhost, as these are peer-reviewed reading materials that will aid the students learning in different subjects. So you can access the EBSCOhost by providing the details projected on your screen. And lastly, we have the Scholastic program. So again, most of you, I think, is familiar with this Scholastic program to provide a remote access to e-resources. So the Scholastic Literacy Pro Library consists of more than 1,000 e-books of non-fiction and fiction readily available for students. The Scholastic offer different titles for their visual reading as well to motivate independent learning. I think nagkamali lang ng slide, so next tayo. So ayan, it is an e-book collection of a wide non-fiction and fiction variety. So for the students' account, the students will be provided their unique username and password for accessibility, and that will be through their email. It will be sent through their email when our school year has started. And that would be all. Thank you and God bless us all. Should you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach us out.
Thank you, Sir Glenn. I hope that we can still maximize the use of our different library services, although we are learning at the comfort of our homes. And our dear parents, please continue to encourage our children to value the importance of reading. In fact, the EBSCOhost and Scholastics are very good platforms to entice our dear Polinians to read at homes. And to discuss some of the important reminders on enrollment procedures and some other concerns, it is my pleasure to introduce to you Ms. Resty Lozarita, our school registrar. Good day, ma'am.
Good day, everyone, especially to our dear parents. I gladly welcome you all to academic year 2021-2022. Thank you for putting your trust in our institution to deliver quality education to your children despite the pandemic. Next slide, please. I am Ms. Resty De Lozarita, PCF registrar, and with me is Mrs. Christine May Pobre, our records in charge. Next slide. Enrollment is ongoing. You may register through the links we'll display. Next slide, please. For request of records like certificate of enrollment, ESS certificate for grade 7 and 10, report cards, Form 138 or SF9, transcript of records, Form 137 or SF10, and other school records, you may send, next slide. You may request, you may send a request by filling out our goal form in the link shown now, or sending our email to registrar@spcmakati.edu.ph. Slide. For incoming grade 7, the form will be sent to your email for those who are not able to accomplish it during the enrollment. For transfers from grades 8 to 10, please secure an ASC certificate from your previous school to continue the subsidy. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you very much, Ms. Resty. And finally, to give us an update on finance concerns, in behalf of Sister Mary Urban Mago SPC, our finance officer, let me introduce to you Mrs. Pinky F. Caragayan, our quality assurance and public relations. Good day, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Ms. Joanne, our very energetic and dynamic facilitator for today's parents' orientation. Good day and peace be with you, dear parents and guardians. Allow me to share to you the prepared speech and presentation of Sister Mary Urban Mago SPC, our finance services head. Next slide, please. First and foremost, I would like to take this chance to thank you in behalf of St. Paul College of Makati administration and staff for your continued support to Polinian education. Thank you for being our supportive partners in our aim to deliver quality education even in the midst of this difficult time. Next slide, please. It has been a year filled with challenges, new discoveries and learnings, as well as new opportunities to improve and develop. It is true because we were able to make it on our virtual class through the implementation of the HIL program last school year 2020-2021. And I would like to congratulate you, dear parents and Polinians, for making it all throughout the school year. Next slide, please. We thank God that we were able to survive another year with you. Next, please. We overlooked some possibilities, occurrences that would affect a slight adjustment in the initial decrease of school fees, which we implemented last year. Next, please. May I present to you the unforeseen occurrences for school year 2020-2021. Let's just make a backtrack of what transpired during the previous school year. First, teachers were foreseen to do online teaching at home, but several went to school because of poor connectivity. With that, computer laboratories and classrooms with full ventilation are used with only two teachers assigned per classroom to avoid audio feedback. With this, two air-conditioned units and lights were working from 7 o'clock to 6 o'clock p.m. because we have to accommodate our a.m. session and p.m. session in our daily schedule. Next slide, please. Second, the science and computer laboratories, machines, equipment, instruments, apparatus, computers, and hardware, peripherals including air-conditioned units, needed regular periodic maintenance and calibration. With that, the outsourced repair of a split-type air conditioning unit costs $17,450 per unit and a maintenance cost of $1,500 per unit. A window type, on the other hand, costs $550 per unit. There are 80 split-type and 191 window type with a total of 271 units. My dear parents, we have to make some recalibration of all our instruments and equipments. Next slide, please. As part of our contextualized bayanihan, no employee was retrenched. And we thank God for that as part or being part of the employees of St. Paul College of Makati. All the employees whose job functions cannot be performed from home report on site and shared tasks and duties available. For example, three staff works in the canteen to maintain it and cook breakfast for the few employees who report on site. So we still provide services for employees who are reporting on site. All the employees were paid their full salaries and thank God, benefits from March 16, 2020 to July 31, 2020, even if they did not report on site due to the declaration of enhanced community quarantine. They were also paid for their unused sick leave. As our immediate help to the employees, each of them were given 50 kilos of rice in June 2020. My dear parents, it was even delivered in our homes. Free delivery. During the height of the lockdowns, sometime in April 2020, we were asked to accommodate several frontliners from the city government of Makati as an extension for our CES activities, community extension services. Our facilities were used as their living quarters for 4.5 months, while 7 of our personnel took charge of preparing 3 square meals for them and 1 auxiliary personnel assigned to regularly clean and disinfect their quarters. Next slide, please. For maintenance concerns, delayed repairs and maintenance of drainage system, leakages, destroyed gutters, classrooms, and offices that are invaded by termites and others. The need to complete all the requirements for the DENR environmental compliance certification of sewer and drainage system. The proliferation of termites in offices. So we do have to make some more we have to do maintenance, okay, for our buildings as well because they are infected by termites. For other expenses, we have the printing of learning packets for 1,080 students damaged heavy-duty printing machine costing to 2.8 million. The learning packets, which we receive quarterly, okay, from the school. Budget of almost $500,000 to develop an online enrollment system and enhance or upgrade our accounting system to accommodate online payments and release online statement of accounts and other online transactions. You know very well that we are limited doing face-to-face activities and therefore we have to do online transactions. For other expenses, we have limited cash flow cost delayed payments to academic partners such as First EduSpec for Robotics, CS21, and Schoology of Rex Bookstore amounting to $6 million. Next slide, please. Decline in enrollment. We know that, our dear parents. Decline in enrollment by 391 students, equivalent to 27% to 37 million plus the average cost of suspended and reduced fees of 22,300 per student, resulting to a total decrease in revenue by 45.9 million. 297 students still received scholarship discounts and grants amounting to 1.6 million plus. All right, may I present to you the schedule of fees for school year 2021-2022 or the current school year. But my dear parents, although there was unseen occurrences during the previous school year, we are assured that for the present school year 2021-2022, there was a very minimal change in the schedule of fees in only some levels. But for other levels, there is the same schedule of fees as that of school year 2020-2021. Please be informed, next slide, please. Please be informed also that items such as the OTG and the student learning journal were reclassified to the learning packet worksheets for all levels this school year 2021-2022. Let's start with the school fees of the pre-kinder. May I enjoin the parents of the pre-kinder to focus their attention on the screen. Thank you. Next slide, please. For the kinder. For our grade one. Grade two. Grade three. Grade four. Grade five. And for our grade six. Let's proceed to the junior high school schedule of fees starting with grade seven. Grade eight. Grade nine. And for grade 10. Let us now proceed to the schedule of fees for the senior high school department. We have the grade 11. Grade 12. Our dear parents, that encapsulates our schedule of fees for our early years department to the senior high school department. Next slide, please. Let us be patient and let us continue to help each other and pray that we will all be able to turn the tide soon and so find ourselves smoothly sailing once again in the rivers of life with God's abounding grace and mercy. Thank you once again, dear parents and guardians, and we earnestly hope to journey with you again for the next school year. Next slide, please. Rest assured of our constant prayers for you and your families, especially for your safety and protection, that I could vouch that the sisters, the community of sisters of SPCM, continually pray for us, okay, daily. They include us in their daily intentions. Next slide, please. With that, once again, that is the report of our finance services head, Sister Mary Urban Mago SPC. Thank you so much for patiently listening. Caritas Christi, urget nos. May the love of Christ impel us all.
Thank you very much, Ms. Caragayan. By the way, I forgot to mention about the difference made mentioned by some of our speakers. Please don't worry, my dear parents, because all the links will be sent via students and parents' account. Thank you. So once again, thank you very much to our dear speakers for your generosity in sharing your discussions for today's orientation. At this juncture, we will proceed to our question and answer. I am going to call our speakers one at a time to address your concern. Okay, so let me start with our Assistant Academic Head, Mr. Raymond Andre Samonte.
Hi, good day again to our dear parents. Thank you very much. I have read the different questions and clarifications. I hope I would be able to answer. Actually, I think I got the most number of questions. All right. So first one is about the learning modules. If they could be given a soft copy. Yes, all of the student accounts and the parent accounts will be forwarded by the soft copy of these modules or of the learning packets, so that if you are located far from Makati, you may be able to print it with the if you have your resources, or probably in overseas. We recognize that we have students overseas and in other places as well. So the soft copy of the modules will be given probably by the third week of July, just after we had printed the learning packet worksheets. So they would be available. And then if we have already the mailing list for the parents and then the students. And then, all right, the schedule of classes will also be given on the first day of classes during the homeroom orientation with the students. And then for the asynchronous part, one parent asked, regarding the asynchronous part of the asynchronous learning, it usually takes place on the other half of the day, wherein you have the home-based tasks, no? And then in connection with this, regarding the number of assignments, since we have now 2 days of two meetings rather in a week for the key learning areas, it's expected that you would have less number of assignments. Because since we have 2 meetings, the teachers would now be able to really guide the students on how to work on the different tasks given to them. No, so it's one of the reasons why we had that kind of arrangement this year, so that we could really mentor and we could really see the outputs of the students. So in connection with this, we also have the tracking of tasks. So some parents ask regarding how can they track the performance tasks of the students, or probably the output submitted. We are currently working on integrating the parent account, the parent's email, into the LMS. We have not yet done that, but we are talking really with the LMS learning integration specialist, because we really want to see, or we really want to have this kind of scenario wherein the parents would be able to see and probably to monitor the different outputs submitted. Okay. So we are trying to work on that. If not, if it may not be possible, we will work on the checklist monitoring system through Google Sheets. This will be shared by the subject teacher, advisor, and the parent, no? So that everybody will be on their toes or be alert if the student had not submitted the outputs. And then the list of requirements and materials is actually ready. It's just that we are waiting lang po for the mailing list for the parents and the students. So the difficulty for us right now is really to come up with the parents' account. So as I had mentioned earlier, so we are just waiting for the mailing lists so that we could have the email blast, no, for these different documents, the list of materials and then the requirements as well. There was also one question regarding the different programs used, like the Photoshop and the AutoCAD. There is no need for you to purchase for that. If ever that you would have that, that would be good. That would be good. That would be okay. If you don't have the program, you will be using a web-based app. It's an online. You have to use your browser to perform the different features of the of these programs. Okay, and then another question was about the parents' meeting. I think this is also in line with the homeroom. Please be informed that we will be scheduling the parents' meeting together with the advisor. So this time, you would get to talk with your class, with the advisors of your children, so that you could also be oriented on some things, no? Because this is a general orientation. So the other specific orientation will be dealt with the advisors. And then Scholastic program is still implemented. That's actually one of the questions. There was also a question on the reduction of background noise. No, we are working with the teachers to minimize this background noise. We are actually using a program right now, so we just have to institutionalize it with the other teachers, so to lessen the background noise during classes. And then there was a suggestion on the PRISM and LEAD session to include child appealing topics. This is noted. We will be suggesting this to the organizers of the program. Okay, for the earlier schedule, it says here that will that be okay if you have a 3 hours rather, no, of classes for early years. Please take note that 3 hours includes already the 30-minute break, also with the 2 10-minute short break for screen time. No, so all in all, there are only about 2 hours and 10 minutes. And then again, this is still divided with the different subjects. And in these different subjects, you also have other activities as well. No, hindi naman po purong turo lang yun, no? So meron pa po silang mga other activities. And then there was one question on the lowest rated service, but please take note po, during the learning preference survey, based on the results, they are not actually they did not receive a low rating. They still had the satisfactory rating. Those are the some student services that are not seen so much, no, like the clinic, no, and then the library, kasi syempre hindi naman po nila masyado nakaka-interact yun. Okay, and then but take note that they are not necessarily not satisfactory. They still have a satisfactory rating. Now for the supplies, if they are open on Saturdays, we are sorry, but we are the staff and the personnel are also also working on a skeletal force. So they are not open, offices are not open on Saturdays. No, but you may communicate with them through email. For the supplies, you may communicate with them through boutique@spcmakati.edu.ph for the uniform. Pasensya na po, marami po talagang tanong. So sinulat ko na po yung mga ibang mga sagot, no? And then another question is about unified submission of requirements. So as I had mentioned earlier, this time we have a policy already to have the submission of outputs only through the LMS. So para hindi na rin po magkalituhan kung ano po yung, kung saan po tayo magsasubmit, sa email po ba, sa Google Drive, or sa LMS. Okay, and then there was another question on home context, because we have about 5 days now of synchronous meetings. may I just ask the parent to communicate with me, because I think this is a very specific home context that that was bring out. So probably we could talk about it and have a win-win solution for this. So and then another one is about the use of webcam. I understand that the that there was a guideline regarding optional turning on of the web camera. What we always say that it is highly encouraged of them to turn on their cameras, no, at all times, so that the teachers can also monitor them. Because we also have this kind of scenario during online class that there are also domestic violence and that teacher cannot do anything about it, or the teacher did not know it because at that time, the teacher is teaching, but the camera is off, the microphone is off, so we cannot also help the student. So hopefully, on this scenario, we would be able to at least look at them, because even if we are teaching, even if we are presenting our lessons, we are still looking at the students' faces, no? So it's also a form of social communication. But of course, we have certain accommodations for that. As halimbawa na lang po, no, the parent, or rather the student, uses only data consumption. He or she can just inform the teacher and then have the camera on during the attendance and then turn off for the rest while listening. So those are some accommodations that we have. No, I think the best learning that we had last year is the word accommodation. The best word that we utilized was accommodation, because we always consider that there is a home context involved. So we just have to communicate with one another what kind of home context would that be. Okay. So again, for monitoring purposes, we really encourage the students to have their cameras on. To protect probably the background and all, if you would see, we had done right now the virtual background for the teachers. So we are also working for the student background for the students, so for the learners, so that their home context, their privacy would not also be compromised. Okay. So we are trying to work on that for another template for the students. Okay, so I hope I was able to answer most questions that you had. If ever there are others, please just let me know. You could also send an email or for inquiry or for clarification to me. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Sir Sam. By the way, Sam, I guess there are some questions that were not addressed. Could you please answer this one po, regarding on the distribution of the OTG and the learning packet?
Sorry, if I got it right, the item for the OTG was reclassified, as mentioned by Ms. Pinky, to the learning packet worksheet. So ibig sabihin po, wala pong OTG this year. It's really the learning packet worksheet. And in terms of the distribution of the learning packet worksheet, please stay tuned on our FB page and on your emails later on, because we will also be informing you of the distribution dates. Currently, it is still up for reproduction po. So stay tuned po on the dates that we will be having. But more likely po, either third or a fourth week of July. Hopefully, we would be able to distribute it before August 2 comes. So thank you.
Thank you very much, Sir Sam. One thing more, one of our parents is asking, since the classes is moved on August 2, when will be the new schedule of dry run class?
Yeah, we'll be updating our schedules as well, because as mentioned, it was only it was only cascaded to us yesterday. So we are still looking into revising the schedule posted on the on our FB page. So please keep updated. We'll also forward it as soon to the parents' email as soon as it is the mailing list is generated. So standby po muna tayo kasi pag-uusapan din po namin muna yung mga adjustments sa schedule. So thank you po.
Thank you very much, Sir Sam. So I guess our homeroom team leader is now ready to answer all your queries. So may I call on Mrs. Luz Sarmiento.
Okay, yes. Good morning once again, dear parents. So I read your questions. So most of them were about the school uniform or the wearing of the school uniform. Yes, really, their parents, we really require them to wear the school uniform for them to feel the school setting. Kasi mas maganda po silang tingnan pag naka-uniform. Kasi last year, we saw some of our students talaga nakapambahay lang. So parang feeling nila nasa bahay lang sila, hindi yung school setting. So we want them, the school setting, na nasa school talaga sila. Okay? Well, anyway, we will consult our new director's principal if we can allow them to wear civilian during online classes. Okay? Now, regarding the leather shoes I mentioned a while ago, that is for the normal classes or the face-to-face classes. So you don't need to buy a pair of it. But, and then for purchasing the school uniform, we will advise our school supplies in charge to make available all the sizes, even the PE uniform. So yun po. So far po about the school uniform lang po yung mga questions. If there are other questions, just send them to us po. Thank you.
Thank you, Ma'am Luz. There is one question for clarification on the school uniform for girls. The parent is asking if it is changed to blouse with navy blue color. Was it changed po to?
Well, no changes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, thank you po, Teacher Luz.
Okay,
so now let's proceed to our guidance counselor, Miss Vanessa Agris.
If there are any questions, please don't forget to send it to our mentee.
Hey, once again, good day. So if you have any questions for the guidance center, kindly send them to our Mentimeter. You can use the code 848-57621.
Miss Vanessa, one of the parents suggests if we can offer webinars for students, even parents, on how to care for mental health considering our current situation. So do you have any programs for that? Thank you po.
Yes po, we are actually, that is part of our programs, no, na to cascade, not just through the Hill Bulletin some information, but also through webinars. So we are planning to have a needs assessment survey so that we will be able to address your concerns appropriately and provide the appropriate programs. As for today, no, the request for that is noted, and we will provide that. We will give you the schedule as soon as the program is finalized. But yes, we will take note of your request for a webinar on mental health and how to do self-care. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Agris. And now let's proceed to our school librarian, To answer all your queries, may I call on now Mr. Arnold Glenn Assis.
So again, good morning, everyone. It was raised that our students allowed to visit the school to borrow books in the library. So yes, if they wish to, as long as they are with their parents or guardians or someone is with them, or for their safety, it can be done through extended delivery services like Lalamove and Grab and other similar services. But take note that the service fee is not provided by the library or by the librarian. And it is still a question, what are relevance of the book since the students are on online classes and may get information via internet? Well, first, not all information is available online. And second, there are many websites that are irrelevant and not reliable, which can lead to dis and misinformation for the students. And don't worry, my dear parents, each classes will be having a separate library orientation. If there are things that is very technical or nor can be understood easily, so with their library orientation, I will be able to guide them and clarify things step by step. So that's all for the library. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sir Glenn. So I hope all your queries were addressed by our librarian. So at this juncture, may I call on Ms. Pinky Caragayan, our Quality Assurance and Public Relations, to answer all your queries regarding to finance.
All right. Good day once again, and peace be with you, our dear parents. When I scrutinized your questions on the Mentimeter, one was, why is there science laboratories for science? And yet our students do not go to school. I mentioned during the presentation under the finance updates and services that one of the unforeseen circumstances last school year was the calibration of science laboratories and equipments. And therefore, my dear parents, for this school year, we have to make the necessary calibration to prevent damage on the computer science laboratory, including the equipment and apparatus. That is why we have science laboratory fee. Second question under finance is, what are the energy fees in breakdown? My dear parents, please acknowledge that even in this time of pandemic, we are in full operation. Energy fees would include electricity bills pertaining to our light consumption and our usage of air conditioning units and other electrical-based facilities in school. It was also made clear that we have to accommodate teachers to teach online here in school due to internet connection problems in their homes. So therefore, they stay in school until from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. in the evening. That's why we also have energy fees included in our fees. Thank you. But if you have other concerns regarding finance updates and services, you are enjoined to send an email to the finance office as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Pinky. And thank you very much to all our speakers for today and all our parent viewers. We are happy for your participation. We are grateful for your patience and trust as we work together to proactively maintain a healthy and protective learning environment for our Polinians. We have now come to the end of this online parent orientation. We would like to thank you for spending your time with us today. And we hope that this will keep you guided as we implement the HEAL Program 2.0 this academic year. We would like also to express our gratitude to all school administrators, headed by our beloved school directress principal, Sister Mirna Castante, SPC, and of course, Mr. Raymond Andre C. Samonte, teachers and staff who extend their big support in making this virtual event possible. By the way, if you still have questions that have not been answered in today's orientation, or if you have further questions, please feel free to send a message at info@spcmakati.edu.ph. And thank you, everyone. And to end this orientation, may I call on once again Mr. John Vincent Perez, subject team leader of CLB department, to lead us all in closing prayer.
Before we have our closing prayer, once again, let us expose ourselves and center our mind and heart to our Lord. Let's be aware of Christ's presence in our hearts and adore His holy name. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, our Father, we thank you for this orientation which gave us enlightenment for all our questions and fears. Together with your Holy Spirit, may we achieve our goals in this school year 2021 to 2022 and be thankful always as one Paulinian community. As we separate virtually, protect and bless as we go onward with our mission as a Paulinian, guardian, parent, employee, and sister. God, our loving Father, you called us to participate in your saving mission and to make you known and loved throughout the world. We thank you for our Paulinian identity that inspires us to be like Christ and to walk in the truth. Help us to stand firm in our daily struggle, to leave our Christocentric Paschal spirituality, forgive our failures, to witness to your compassionate love, and to surrender to your holy will. Grant us the grace to grow in your love for the good of the church and the service of neighbor, and to remain faithful to you, to your Son, Jesus Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Mary, our mother and model, pray for us. St. Paul, our patron, pray for us. Father Louis Chauvet and the First Sisters, intercede for us. May the love of Christ impel us, now and forever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you very much, Sir Vincent. I guess I can still see lots of questions coming in our Mentimeter. My apologies if we cannot address all your queries as of now because we need to cut our online parents orientation. But please don't worry, our dear parents. We still have another set of orientation to be given by our advisors. And if you think that we need to address your concern immediately, please feel free to send your question again at info@spcmakati.edu.ph. Thank you very much. Please continue to visit the SPCM official Facebook page to keep posted of the upcoming events and announcements. We also encourage everyone to please do share our post and please do not forget to use the hashtag OnwardsSPCM. Thank you very much once again. I am Miss Mary Joanne G. Marquez, Caritas Christi Urget Nos.